The plumbing system in your home is comprised of many different parts that work together to make everything run smoothly. When a part of the system isn't working properly, it could lead to the entire system being disrupted. If you have any issues with your plumbing system, there are ways to combat the problems that may be caused. If you experience a plumbing leak, the first thing to do is turn off the water. Individual shutoff valves are typically located at each sink and toilet. Using the individual shutoffs allows you to continue to use water in the rest of the home. However, if you can't isolate the leak, you may need to shut off the water to your entire home. The main water valve may be located under your home or in your utility room. It's generally easy to spot because it's a large, red-handled valve. On some manufactured homes, there will not be individual shutoff valves at each sink and appliance, but there will be a shutoff valve that operates the entire home plumbing system. Check with the manufacturer of your home to find out if your home has individual shutoff valves or just a main shutoff valve. If you can't find the main water shutoff valve, call your friendly home consultant and they will be able to help you locate it over the phone. In some cases, there may be another main shutoff valve in your yard or at the street. Take a moment to locate this valve as you may need to use it in case of an emergency. Once it's shut off, contact a licensed plumbing specialist for assistance. Along with the main water line, your home also has a main sewer or septic line for your sinks, bathtubs, and toilets. If your system gets clogged to the point where you can't relieve the blockage with a plunger, you may need to clean out the main system using the main cleanout. If this is required, we recommend that you hire a professional plumber to address the situation. Sometimes the water flow from a faucet becomes restricted or unsteady, which probably means the aerator is clogged. An aerator is a series of screens that controls how much water comes out of the faucet. The aerator divides the water into multiple streams, allows the water to mix with the air, and creates a measured, consistent flow. It's not unusual for the water flow from the faucet to be temporarily unsteady if another faucet or appliance in your home is using water at the same time. If the water flow from the faucet is unsteady or seems restricted when nothing else in your home is using water, it might mean the aerator is clogged. To unclog the aerator, first unscrew the aerator, take out the screen, and clean it to remove any blockages. Place the aerator back in position and the water flow should return to normal. If this doesn't resolve the issue, the unsteady flow is typically the result of pressure fluctuations in the supply of water to your home. If your home is connected to the municipal system, contact your local utility company and notify them of the issue. If your home is connected to a well system, contact the company that installed the well system or a plumbing professional for further assistance. Your home has either a gas or electrical water heater. You can increase efficiency and save money by not overheating your water. The temperature of the water heater is preset to 105 degrees, and we recommend keeping it at that temperature. You do have some room to adjust the temperature of the water heater if desired, but the temperature should not be set above 130 degrees. You'll also save money and energy by turning the heater down when leaving for vacation or for prolonged periods of time. Toilets installed in Clayton-built homes today use low-capacity 1.6-gallon tanks. These use less water per flush, saving hundreds of gallons of water each year. Sink traps are designed to help eliminate sewer gas. The water that's in the trap acts as a barrier, blocking unwanted odors. In bathrooms where sinks, showers, and bathtubs are not regularly used, run water into the drain once a month to keep the trap working. If you live in an area where your temperature falls below freezing in the winter months, be sure to disconnect your lawn hose from the outside faucets so that water will not freeze in the line, because this could potentially lead to issues with the water line. Now that you're aware of the different parts of your plumbing system, you should be able to handle almost any situation if needed. Remember, in case of a plumbing emergency, do what you can to stop the water flow, then contact a professional if necessary. If you have any additional questions, feel free to contact your local home center or the home building facility where your home was built for assistance.